Europa, we've been fascinated with since the Voyagers went by in the 70s and 80s. The Voyagers were launched in the 70s and came back with this first image of Europa, which kind of blew everybody away because it looks so really bizarre. It's got all this exotic terrain and all of these lines. But the first thing that struck was the fact that you don't see any cratering. So this must be a very young surface to not have any craters. So it must be constantly renewing or reforming itself somehow, which indicates water underneath the surface. And some of this terrain looks very much like the ice sheets as they move around and jostle each other with the changing seasons around Antarctica. So it was thought that there must be a lot of water here. The Thera and Thrace macula are similar but different. This one, the Thera macula, is actually lower than the surrounding terrain. It has collapsed somewhat into the surface of Europa. And over here, the Thrace macula is elevated above the surface. So this is an indication that maybe there is a lot of water mobility fairly close to the surface on Europa that would allow some melting to take place for this one to sink, and maybe some icy warm slush or water rising up to elevate this particular part of the terrain. The Conamara Chaos is a section where it looks like the surface kind of partially melted and big blocks of ice became tilted and rotated and half submerged and then refroze out of some slushy environment again and led to all of these really odd and strange blocks of stuff on the surface. And embedded within this are these really bizarre ridges, double ridges even, very straight lines. Some of them are very straight lines. Now, this is Europa. It's next to Jupiter. There are a lot of other moons of Jupiter, too. So between the tidal forces, the tidal stress, the gravitational forces of Jupiter on Europa and all of the other moons on Europa, there's a lot of stress is put on the surface of this particular moon. And so there are places where the surface is being squeezed together, places where it's being pulled apart or sliding back and forth past each other. And then there are these cycloids. Now, what on earth could cause such a bizarre feature as this? Well, it was first thought that Europa was in synchronous rotation, but it is not locked into a synchronous rotation with Jupiter. It orbits as it rotates. So what you're seeing here are the result, probably, of rotating diurnal stress fields as it rotates and orbits because of the gravitational stresses and tidal forces being exerted on it by Jupiter. It changes the direction of the force. So it changes the direction of the force. And then all of a sudden, because of the orbital motions, the force is in a different direction and has this cycle of little bizarre things like this. And there are some places where it cycles like that, and then it's a straight line, and then it cycles. So does it do these little cycloids and then become straight for a while and then cycle again? We don't know. But obviously, there is a lot of movement underneath the surface. Again, there are some planes, very few short little planes in there, but almost no cratering, so there has to be a lot of water very close to the surface. And as a matter of fact, they have calculated that here is a schematic that shows the comparison of the volume of water on Europa and the volume of water on the surface of the planet Earth. 70% of Europa might very well be water. A huge amount of water on a much smaller moon. So we are very interested in that. And there is a planned mission, the JUICE mission, the juicy juice being Jupiter and ice, that is being planned by the European Space Agency in collaboration with some people here in the United States working on that. to send juice to Europa in 2022 just to study the subsurface condition of Europa, where they expect to find tons and tons of H2O. Enceladus is a bizarre looking moon of Saturn. It has cratered areas, it has uncratered areas, it has fissures, it has plains, and it has this weird corrugated, wrinkly kind of stuff. This might be a similar condition to Jupiter and Io, where the stresses on poor little Io from both Jupiter and the other moons are literally pulling that little moon apart and producing all of that volcanism. There might be the same similar effect here, here on Enceladus, on parts of it. And in the South Pole region, they have found about 98 geysers, jets and plumes of water and icy particles and organic materials that are being squeezed out of the surface of Enceladus because of all of these tidal forces interacting below the surface. So that is thought to be another location of a huge amount of water